This is SportsCenter with Elle Duncan and Kevin Nagandi.
These are all big truths. Hi, hello, I'm Elle, he's Kevin. The Big Ten is battling in week 9 of college football, right? We're going to preview what promises to be a fantastic weekend of football.
Plus, Dan Orlovsky on how the Packers' defense can slow down the Cardinals' high-octane offense tonight, and the latest around Dak Prescott's health.
A significant loss, him and Alan Lazard. We go to Arizona, where we're joined by reporter Coley Harvey alongside Monday Night Football's Lewis Riddick. Lewis, hang tight. I'm going to start with Coley. We did mention as well, J.J. Watt is likely done for the year. The good news for that Arizona pass rush, as you know, Chandler Jones back in the fold after missing two games because of COVID-19. What's the team expecting from him in his return? Really, that despite how good that offense is, right, they've been the pride of the desert, that defense, the number one scoring defense in the NFL. Lewis, on the other side, the Packers going to be without their top three receivers tonight. What's going to be the key for Green Bay's offense to be successful? As we like to overhype things, but how about this? A 13-1 combined record between these two teams, the best combined winning percentage by teams to ever play on a Thursday night football game in October or later in a season. Hopefully it lives up to all of that hype. Coley Harvey and Lewis Riddick both going to be back on SportsCenter in a little bit to talk more. Thanks, guys. Guess who's here? Dan Orlovsky of NFL Live fame. Hi, Dan.
What's up?
Glad to have you here. I would not be audacious enough to say how are the Packers going to stop Kyler Murray and the Cardinals, but how about slow down?
Yeah, I have no idea what audacious means. I think, first of all, for the Green Bay
Packers. Taylor Heinicke out there looking like Mike Vick last week. Yeah, everywhere. 95 yards last week. They did get the win, though, did Green Bay. I want to talk about the Cowboys, Dak Prescott, his status for their game Sunday night against Minnesota. Still up in the air. If he's not 100%, how should the Cowboys approach his availability?
Well, I think that everything I've seen and heard, go out there and play and not risk further significant damage, then he's likely to play, and as he should. But if there's risk to do something long-term to that calf, then you have to be smart and kind of lose the...
It's crazy. It feels like all of a sudden we're talking about Dak Prescott and injuries a lot, when really he was an Iron Man up until last year. All 11 games that he missed in his entire six-year career all came last year. So this could be the first time we see him miss a game not off of that broken ankle. Dan Orlovsky joining us here to break down the NFL Week 8. Let's go. Boom, week boom, 8? Boom. Halfway yet? No. Of a bombshell investigation of the Chicago Blackhawks, the fallout continues from their failure to act when a video coach was accused of sexual assault against a player in 2010. In tonight's SportsCenter report, Emily Kaplan has the latest news on the team's former head coach, who this season had been riding high in Florida until disturbing allegations against. Quinville isn't the only former Blackhawks leader mentioned in the report that is still in the league. Winnipeg Jets GM Kevin Cheveldayoff, an assistant GM with the Blackhawks in 2010, will meet with Gary Bettman in the coming days. And after saying for months that Beach's lawsuit against the team had no merit, the Blackhawks now say they want to reach a settlement.
I just want to see how Patrick Mahomes handles things. I mean, how many
I can't believe there's intrigue surrounding that and the Giants, but that's where we're at. I love it here. Danny Nichols.